رحمن يا رحمن ساعدني يا رحمن
يا رحمن
رحمن يا رحمن ساعدني يا رحمن
يا رحمن.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. ثم أما بعد. My dear brothers and my dear sisters in Islam, no doubt, and there should be no doubt, in the minds and more importantly in the hearts of every single Muslim here and on the face of this earth, that the sunnah of our Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam is the most important thing to them and to the islah and the rectification of this ummah. But that word sunnah comes under that word many, many things. And one of the sunan of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and one of the sunan of His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is lacking in us. Wallahi, it's lacking. It's lacking at the personal level, personal interactions from one person to the other, from a parent to his child, from a child to his parent, spouses among one another, siblings among one another. And just a Muslim brother to his brother and a sister to her sister. And then at a societal level, the way we treat one another as a community, whether you're black, white, Arab, non-Arab, and then as a species, as a human race, how we treat one another. And especially, who cares how the kuffar treat us? Because they have no control. It's in Allah's hands. But more importantly, what you will be asked for about Yawm al-Qiyamah is how you treat other people. Enemy, friend, Muslim, non-Muslim. And that sunnah, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, that sunnah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and that sunnah of His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam is called rahmah. It's called mercy. Maghfira, forgiveness. Sabr, patience and forbearance. And of course, there's no way ever for me or anybody alive to demonstrate or to explain in 23 minutes or 20 minutes what it is, the rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is. But we can take some examples from the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, one ayah, and we'll expound on it a little bit, and some examples from the life of our beloved sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says in the book, or in His book, Jalla wa ala, wa rahmati wasi'at kulla shay'. And my rahmah, and my mercy, and my forbearance It has encompassed everything. Think about it. As a human being living in 2017 and not in 686 or even the 18th century, what does it mean to you, my dear brother and my dear sisters? When